Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Myself, Yosna Kumawat. I am lecturer in Chemical Engineering of KQR Polytechnic National. Today, in this video, I am going to teach you how the ethanol is formed from the corn. In this video, I will discuss which are the different unit processes and the unit operation occurring for the formation of ethanol from the corn. Mainly, this method takes place by fermentation method, and after the distillation is carried out, and finally we get our ethanol in this process. The corn ethanol produced from the corn biomass, and it is produced by fermentation and distillation processes. The corn undergoes many processing steps before it can be ready for fermentation for ethanol production. The corn is shelled to remove the kernels from pulp, followed by the separation of impurities such as stones, sticks stored in seed. Generally, this method is based on the biotechnology process and is very useful for the formation of ethanol from the corn. In this method, we use corn kernel, water, sulfuric acid, ammonia, and yeast as the raw materials. This method is followed by three steps. First is conversion of starchy feedstock into fermentable sugar. Second step is fermentation, and lastly, the purification or distillation of the material takes place in this purification process. In the conversion of starchy feedstock, three unit operations are performed. First is milling, second is liquefaction, and third one is enzyme-based sacrification. In milling process, the conversion of corn into the powder takes place. Then its liquefaction takes place where the water is added in that and it is converted into the starch. And after that, the enzyme-based sacrification process takes place. Enzyme-based sacrification is the process of breaking a complex carbohydrate into the monosaccharide components. Means in this, we are converting starch or cellulose into the sugary solution, that is glucose. After the sacrification, it is sent to the fermentation tank, where the fermentation takes place in presence of yeast, and we get the ethanol from the sugary substances. Then after fermentation, it is sent to the purification step where the unwanted byproducts are removed, unwanted solids and yeast is removed, and we get the pure ethanol in this purification or distillation process. This is the process flow diagram of formation of ethanol from the corn. First, the grains of corn are stored in the grain storage tank, and from the storage tank it is sent to the milling process. Milling process consists of wet milling and the dry milling process, where the milling of corn means its conversion into the powder takes place. After milling, it is sent to the cooking tank, where it is cooked in presence of water, and in cooking its microorganisms are Some unwanted microorganisms are removed from the starch. Then after cooking, it is sent to the liquefaction, where it is liquefied and the sacrification takes place here. And in this process, this corn gets converted into the starch, and starch gets converted into the glucose solution. And this glucose solution gets sent to the fermentation tank, where in presence of yeast, this sugary solution get fermented at 30 to 40 or 30 to 70 hours, depending upon the sugary solution. And this process takes place at 20 to 30 degrees Celsius. And here, some amount of ammonia is also added to maintain the pH. And this ammonia is also served as a nutrient to the yeast also. And after the fermentation of some hours, it is sent to the distillation column, where the distillation of this fermented alcohol takes place, and from this distillation column, a fuel ethanol is removed from the distillate section, and the solid wet distilled grains are removed from the bottom section. This fuel ethanol is stored and sent to the market, where it is used. And the bottom product from the distillation column, that is wet distilled grain, are dried, and now they become a dry distiller's grain, that is called as DDG also, and it is sent to the market, and it serves as a cattle feed or the animal food also. Now we will see the one by one unit operation. I have already told you the milling process takes place or either wet milling or either dry milling. In wet milling, this corn kernels is soaked in water and dilute sulfuric acid at 52 degrees Celsius and for 24 to 36 hours. Before grinding the kernels into the mash in order to facilitate the grain component segregation. This soaking separates the germ, gluten, and the fiber and starch from the corn oil. The starch is separated with the help of centrifugation or screening or with the help of hydrochloric separator. Other than starch, some liquor is also present, and that liquor is dried and filtered out. And from that, the corn gluten is formed. Corn gluten is nothing but the protein-rich product which is separated from the starch, and it is sold to the livestock industry. It is the byproduct of this process. And our main focus is on starch. This starch is then sent to the saccharification process, and then the subsequent steps of ethanol production takes place. Next is dry milling process. In the dry milling process, the whole corn kernel is ground into a powder and mixed with the water to form a mash, in which liquefying enzymes are added to break down the starch into the simple sugar. To control the pH, ammonia is added, and it is also served as a nutrient to the yeast. The mash is then cooked. And after milling, the formed mash is then cooked to avoid the bacterial contamination, and it is proceeded to the saccharification step, in which the liquefied starch is hydrolyzed to glucose with the saccharifying enzyme. Then after cooling, this mash is sent to the subsequent steps of ethanol formation. Then after saccharification, it is sent to the fermentation, where the glucose-rich mash is converted into the ethanol in 30 to 40 hours at mesophilic temperature, means at near about 20 to 30 degrees Celsius. And in order to reduce this residence time of 30 to 40 hours, the applications of simultaneous saccharification and fermentation is generally used, where the glucomylase and the yeast are added simultaneously. The resulting mixture from the fermentation consists of 15% ethanol and solid and some added yeast also. This is pumped to the multi-column distillation system, where the ethanol is separated from the remaining stevia. In distillation column, 93 to 95% pure ethanol is obtained, and it is dehydrated by passing it through the molecular sieves. Molecular sieves is a microporous substance, and when we pass this 93 to 95% pure ethanol through the molecular sieves, the water which is present in this ethanol is gate trapped and absorbed on the surface of the molecular sieves, and finally we get the 99% pure ethanol. This 99% pure ethanol is then denatured by adding the denatured chemicals like natural gasoline, ethanol, etc., and its amount is 1.7625%. And why we are adding the denaturant? Because after addition of denaturant, its drinkable quality changes, means it becomes undrinkable, and because of that, it becomes free of alcohol tax. And after distillation, the solid which are removed are dried and they are sent to the feed market and they can be used as a value added product. So in this way, the ethanol formation process from the corn takes place. It is a very useful method for the formation of ethanol from corn. So thank you everyone for watching my video. I hope you have understood the process of formation of ethanol from corn. If you like my video, then please press the like button and subscribe my channel. I will meet you soon with my next video. Thank you once again.